It's a pleasure to be here, thank you. Mentioned that we have some family connections. My grandmother was from Manchester, so we're going there tomorrow, 40 years since the last time, so I can't believe I'm that old. I just wanted to mention briefly a few things about the recital. In considering the repertoire to do, because all of the performers this weekend have done Vienne, I wanted to go a little deeper into things that I haven't personally experienced. And when I found the triptych, I connected with it on a variety of levels. My understanding is that that was actually the last piece he performed right before he passed. And when I was 16 years old, I had the privilege to go to Paris to play organs, and they still have the bench he was sitting at there next to the organ. I got to sit on it and take a picture, and so it was an interesting full circle to have that connection. And so from there, I decided that I would like to do all triptychs. And just a quick note, the first triptych is by one composer, a Dutch composer. He's at the famous Zwolle Church. And I've really enjoyed his music. I lived for a couple of years there studying and got to meet him at one point. And so it's a very, he has a unique way of getting new sounds out of old instruments. So I think that you'll enjoy that. The Impressionistic triptych came out of a desire to include the Clair de Lune program, and of course everyone knows Debussy's famous clarinet. This particular one by Vienne uses the same source melody, and it's actually dedicated to a very famous American organ builder, Ernest Skinner. So I like that connection. And then I have two young daughters, they're 4 and 7, and miniature humans with opinions, I call them, but they love Debussy's Children's Corner Suite. So the other two selections are adaptations that I've made from that suite for organ. And then the final one is an opportunity to share just a little bit of flavor of America. All three of these are living composers, and their pieces represent different aspects of the cultural history of America. And specifically, the middle one resonates with me. I was born in the heart of what is the traditional Navajo lands, and I've always been fascinated by that culture. Connor G is a young pianist, and this is his first composition organ. But I wanted to just show you briefly what a Native American flute looks and sounds like, because that's the source material of his inspiration. I have a little travel one. It's a little hard to play. I'm probably the most nervous about this, but I'm just going to play a little bit on this so you can get a sense of its sound. I think you'll hear a little bit of that in the Navajo piece. But thank you so much for this opportunity, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
there was a piece I wanted to include on the program, but it didn't fit the theme. This was composed by an Eastern European woman who teaches in the Netherlands composition. And it was composed at the retirement of Pope Benedict XVI. And this is a prayer piece dedicated to him and then revised upon his death. An interesting thing to note is it uses the note B flat 16 times in the pedal. B flat is a traditional note for B, and of course, Benedict is 16. So I'd like to leave you with this prayer. Thank you.
happy to conclude so beautifully this series, and hopefully we'll see you next year for another series of concerts in this lovely French organ. Have a good evening. Thank you for your support, if you can, we'll be very grateful.